This Week at NASA. Expedition 36 flight engineers Chris Cassidy of NASA and Luca Parmitano of the European Space Agency will venture outside the International Space Station twice in July on spacewalks to prepare for a new Russian module and perform additional installations on the station's backbone. The EVAs, scheduled for July 9th and July 16th, were previewed for the media during a briefing at the Johnson Space Center. NASA TV coverage of the spacewalks will begin at 7 a.m. Eastern on both days. This time-lapse movie made from a sequence of images captured by NASA's Hubble Space Telescope shows Comet Ison speeding toward the Sun at 48,000 miles per hour and resembling a skyrocket from a fireworks show. Happy 4th of July from the cosmos.
Ames Research Center recently co-hosted the 10th Annual International Planetary Probe Workshop, or IPPW, at nearby San Jose State University. The workshop included presentations related to planetary science, asteroids, comets, and moons, as well as a keynote address by NASA Ames Director of Engineering David Korsmeyer. Invited participants also had an opportunity to tour facilities at Ames and meet some of the people developing new designs and solutions for planetary entry systems. While San Jose's Tech Museum of Innovation provided exhibits and displays for the general public featuring thermal protection materials and models of spacecraft.
Young scientists participating in the Student Spaceflight Experiments program discussed their work with recent experiments on the space shuttle and on the space station during the 2013 SSEP National Conference at the Smithsonian National Air and Space Museum in Washington.
NASA is a shining example of reaching out through education and public outreach to get the next generation of scientists and engineers excited. And here we're making use of commercial access to the International Space Station.
Launched in June 2010, SSEP is a national science, technology, engineering, and mathematics education initiative that typically gives 300-plus students an opportunity to design and propose real experiments to fly in low Earth orbit.
A small wing section has been undergoing flight tests on an F-15 aircraft at NASA's Dryden Flight Research Center. The tests are designed to gauge the airfoil's ability to maintain smooth laminar airflow at supersonic speeds. Flown in partnership with Aerion Corporation, the tests could lead to refined airfoil designs that would increase aerodynamic efficiency while reducing fuel consumption of future supersonic aircraft.
On July 7, 2003, Opportunity, the second of the two Mars exploration rovers, was launched from Cape Canaveral aboard a Delta II rocket. Opportunity landed on Mars on January 25, 2004, 3 weeks after its twin Spirit touched down on the red planet. While Spirit became immobile in 2009 and ceased communications in 2010, Opportunity remains active and continues to gather scientific observations and report back to Earth. Two moons orbiting Pluto recently discovered with the help of the Hubble Space Telescope have new names. The moon formerly designated as P4, found in 2011, has been named Kerberos, while the new moniker of the former P5, a moon discovered in 2012, is Styx. Like the rest of Pluto's moons, the names are from characters associated with the mythological god Pluto, ruler of the underworld. Kerberos is the three-headed guard dog of the underworld, while Styx is the river that separates the underworld from the world of mortals. NASA's New Horizons spacecraft is scheduled to visit Pluto and its moons in July 2015. And that's This Week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, or to follow us on Foursquare, Twitter, and other social media, log on to www.nasa.gov.